Hello, everybody. Welcome back. We are now on 9.3. Quadratic inequalities in two variables. These are essentially where you're going to have a quadratic. It looks like a quadratic function, right? Opposed to an equation in the previous section. So a quadratic. You basically have a quadratic function here with an inequality. So we have the y equals. So we're actually going to graph the quadratic, and we're going to shade either x cal inside the quadratic or outside the quadratic. Similar to what we did in linear inequalities in the first section, 9.1, and what you're accustomed to when we learned the math 11. Okay, the last section was new to us in one variables. If it was me, I would have interchanged the sections. I probably would have, if I was the author, I would have done 9.3 as 9.2 and vice versa, but that's only my opinion. So in recap, a quadratic inequality in one variable looks like this. Its solution is expressed in interval as intervals, right? Now we're going to express it on a graph. This is for two variables when we have the y included in, and we graph the quadratic, and then we shade above or below, okay? So, or inside and outside, I guess, if you wish, whatever. Every way you want to look at it. Same thing goes for with linear inequalities. It's a dotted or dashed or broken line, if you wish. For less than or greater than, and if it's less than or equal to greater than or equal, then we just have a solid line that we're accustomed to. So let's look at this first example. It says graph y is less than or equal to x squared minus 2x minus 3. Step 1, find the x-intercepts factor. Little smiley face, you know we need a factor here. Draw the boundary line. And remember, if it's less than or greater than, it's broken or dashed. And remember, if it's less than or equal to greater than or equal, that gets a solid line. Then you do a test point like we did with linear, and it's done. This is really pretty straightforward for you guys. If the coordinates of the test point satisfy the inequality, then the shaded region includes that test point, as you guys are aware. So the first one we're going to do is we'll factor this. So we have y less than or equal to x squared, so we just take it, factor it, get the x values, so it's 3 and negative 1, so negative 1 here, and 3 here. Pick the test point, 0, 0, which is clearly here. Substitute it back into the original inequality. So 0 is less than 0 squared minus 2 times 0 subtract 3. Is 0 less than negative 3? No. Do not shade the region with 0, 0. If you have issues with graphing that, you can use the Desmos program to help you. Or just remember, you'll notice on my graph, I have four key points here. The two x-intercepts, the y-intercept, as well as the vertex. That'll allow you to draw a nice, smooth curve through, and remember to draw with the dotted or dashed or broken because it is just less than. If it was less than or equal to, that would just be solid like you're accustomed to. That's it. Really, that's how we solve inequalities with two variables. So essentially graph the equation and shade the correct region. So I had to shade all the way around because 0, 0, or origin, was not a test point. I use 0, 0 if possible. If not, you just use whatever you can. It doesn't make a difference. Let's look at a second example. It says graph the inequality y is greater than or equal to 2x squared plus 8. Verify using a test point. So we have y is greater than or equal to negative 2x squared plus x. So now we do as we solve for x. This one doesn't need to be factored because there's no b value in the trinomial. We just have a x squared and a constant, so we can literally just solve. So we take the 8 over, divide both sides by 8. But remember, when you solve, you're going to have the square root of 4, which is going to be plus or minus 2. So essentially, we have the values. You could have factored that, although if you wanted to, I can show you how to factor that just in a minute. I'll show you what that looks like for factoring. So if you did want to factor that this one here, move that over a little bit. So you could factor it. You could take this once you set it equal to 0, right? And you could factor out the negative 2. Factor out the negative 2, that leaves me with x squared minus 4, and then you have the difference of squares, which to work with here. And we know this is the difference of squares, so we have x, so it'll be x minus 2, x plus 2, which is fine. That works as well. And then obviously x is equal to plus or minus 2. So either way works. Okay? And then we just graph it. So we have x is 2, so we have the negative 2 and positive 2 as your x-intercepts. Your y-intercept comes from positive 8 there. And that's all you need. Ends up being just your vertex because there's no b-value, right? If you did minus b over 2a, be negative 0, so it would be 0 for your x value. So the y-intercept is your vertex in this particular case. And then we just graph down, test point 0, 0 here. Plug them in, 0 greater than or equal to negative 2 multiplied by 0 squared plus 8. So 0 is greater than or equal to 8, which we say, no, that's not true. So we do not shade the region with 0, 0, right? If it's a, you get a yes, then you shade this region here. Okay? So in this example, this is just take each ordered pair and determine whether it's a solution or not. So if you plug it into your inequality and the inequality holds true, then it's a solution. If it doesn't, then it's no. So on the first one here, we have negative 3 as your x value, 8 as your y value. You plug in 8 for y and negative 3 for x. So we get negative 3 squared is 9. 9 times 3 is 27. 27 subtract 4 is 23. Is 8 greater than or equal to 23? No, it's not. So therefore, it's basically a test point is what you're doing, essentially, here, right? Okay? If you determine whether the ordered pair is a solution, you're essentially testing whether or not it's basically what side you shade, right? So it's basically algebraic. Do the same thing with negative 5, 12. Again, you get end up getting 12 is greater than or equal to 7. You know, that's not the case. And then the last one here, 0 and 5. 5 is greater than or equal to negative 4, so yes, that is. Okay. Example, are the points on the graph y equals 4x squared minus 3x plus 7 part of the solution in the inequality y? And so think about that for a minute. So are all the points on this graph included in this? No, because of this simple sign here of greater than. If it was greater than or equal to or less than or equal to, then it would be the case, right? Remember, the solution to this equation, quadratic equation, is only the values that lie on the directly on the curve. Here, that's not the case, right? So, pretty neat. But remember, when you have inequalities, it's not just the points that are on the curve; it's all the points that are either inside the quadratic or outside or above or below, whatever way you want to look at it. Okay. Just graph the inequality. Y is greater than or equal to x plus 2 all squared. Write the coordinates of the two points that satisfy this inequality. So I do the test point shading the region. So to answer the question, you would just pick any two coordinates that are inside here, right? So just basically do just a couple of more test points. That's all. I didn't do that. I do apologize, but that's all we need to do in this particular case. So maybe I'll do that now. So I've just gotten my Word document open here, and to pick any two points, you can check if they satisfy, but I just do that in my head, and I just pick the points that satisfy, right? 2 points. And what are the 2 points? One is clearly 0 and 10, right? You can clearly see that 0 and 10 satisfies it, and then, I mean, you could pick negative 2 and 10 as well. Remember, there's an infinite number of solutions. That'll happen here. You can pick any points that are inside the shaded region. Right? So your test point wasn't. Your test point could be one that satisfies it, essentially, but in this case it didn't. So that tells us where to shade, and then we go from there. So it says graph this inequality. So we graph the inequality y equals, it's in vertex form, as you'll notice. So the vertex is 1 and 5. The a value is 2, so it opens upward. So it doesn't have any x-intercepts. It just has a y-intercept and a vertex, and you can shade the region. When you do the test point, zero did satisfy it, so there's a lot of points that will work here. So again, these are just 2 points that I've picked. There's an unlimited number of there's an infinite number of points, right, that will satisfy this. So one, for example, would be you clearly see that, well, 0, 0 could work, but I mean you could put 5 and 0, right? You can see that this point here clearly is there. You can put 5 and 5, right, or 6 and 6, or 5 and 10. It doesn't, you know, there's an infinite number, right? So I'll use 5 just because my graph's showing 5 and 10. Right, so 5 and 0, 5 and 10, 5 and 5, negative 5, 10, negative 5, 5. Any, basically any coordinates down there would be negative work. So that's what that question meant. I forgot to put that in, so I do apologize. Oh, now this one's a neat. Determine the equation of the following inequalities. So this is something that we've done. We've already know how to come up with an equation. We've done this in Math 11, but now we're just going to stick the inequality sign in, right? So I used vertex form, one of the easier forms to look at, because this clearly the vertex is 0 and 1, and they've labeled 2 other points. So I've picked 2 and 3, put it in to solve the a value. At a value is a half, so there's my equation. All right, so I just plug in to obtain my a value, which you guys are capable of. We did that in Math 11 many a times. We did it in this course as well. And then we have y equals 1 half bracket x squared plus 1, because there's no minus 0 for the vertex form, right, because 0 there. So pick a test point. I picked the test point 0 and 2 to make it work, because I know that it satisfies this. When I plug it in the equation 1 and 2, I get 1 is equal to 2. So we change it to 1 is greater than or equal to 1. So therefore, our inequality is y is greater than or equal to 1 half x squared plus 1. So up to this point, it's identical to what we did in Math 11, just obtaining the equation in vertex form based on the graph. Pick the vertex, pick any other point other than the vertex, obviously, and solve. And then pick a test point that is clearly in the shaded region. So that's why I didn't pick 0, 0 this time. I picked 0 and 2 because it was clearly in the shaded region. So we wanted to satisfy that. You could pick 0 and 0 to the opposite. I think I did that before, but that's probably not a great choice. So I get 2 is equal to 1. We know that's not true. So we take the inequality greater than or equal to, which makes it true. So y is greater than or equal to 1 half x squared plus 1. You don't need the brackets, but I just show that vertex form. And the last one here, same idea. So this one opens downward. We picked 1, 3. There's your vertex here. I picked any other point. I picked 4 and 0. I solved for my a value. A value is negative 1 third. I plug that in, obtain my equation. Y equals negative 1 third is your a value. X minus p. P was 1. And our q value is 3, so it's plus 3. Plug in a point to satisfy. So I picked 3 and 3 here. That's the point I picked, the test point, right? Because it's right here. We know that should satisfy it. So I ended up getting 3 is equal to 5 thirds. We know that's not true. So we picked the inequality that makes that true. So 3 is greater than, it shouldn't be greater than or equal to, actually. I do apologize. That should be just greater than, not the equal sign, because it is dashed. Or this one is dotted. So I will fix that now. It should be just greater than, and that should be greater than as well, because it is dashed or dotted or broken. So there's the textbook questions, page 496, numbers 1 through 7 and number 9, to practice with some of these shader regions. So that's it for chapters 8 and 9. We're all finished there. We will continue on next with chapter 5 when we're looking at radicals. Hope everybody's doing well, and we'll see you guys again soon.